Mr. Morgan, you're quite a sight.
What's that?
You're revolting, and you'll get all of us sick. Come with me.
Ooh. I'm sort of busy right now.
I wasn't asking. I'm telling. My camp, my rules. Come on. Get.
Here's some money for your troubles.
Why, thank you, kind sir.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again, if you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
Mr. Morgan, can I? Are you okay?
Yes. I was miles away, I'm afraid.
So it seems. Anyway, it's that fellow Downs.
The do-gooder?
Exactly. We lent him quite a sum. It seems like he has little intention of repaying us. He was quite ridiculous when I went to see him. You've not been to see him yet, I take it?
I'm sorry, Herr Strauss. Had a lot on. I'll go give him a gentle reminder.
Not so gentle. I don't like his kind. Superior.
As you wish.